Welcome to Grow With Angie. I'm Angie, and I'm going to be doing a science experiment with you today. I want to try and answer some questions about pH and EC levels, but I'm going to do this on a very beginner level. The iHarvest is so popular that it was backordered for quite a while, and they just started shipping, and the questions are flooding in. And everybody keeps asking, how much do I add of either pH or of the nutrients or Calmag or hydrogen peroxide? What do I do? And I always really feel bad because I can't just come back with an answer and say 1 tablespoon per gallon. It doesn't work like that, and I really want to break it down as easily as I can and let you know why I can't just give you that answer. If you have questions while this is going on, please post them below and I'll try and answer it or maybe clarify it for you a little bit better. Let's start out with the different types of meters. Now, this is an EC and a pH meter. This one is an EC only, and this one is a pH only. I'm gonna go ahead and use this one because it has both in it at the same time. Let's take a look at these different waters that I have out in front of me. I have one jar that is full of distilled water, one that has tap water in it, and one that has filtered water in it. The tap water that I use, or what comes out of my faucet, is actually well water. And I'm gonna get some comments below it, and go ahead and bring it on if you want to with the hydroponic groups that I actually use a water softener. Not only do I add salt for my water softener, but I also use a rust remover. And if you want to sit there and argue with me about using a water softener and I should bypass it, tell that to the plants behind me because I don't think they really care. I have never had a problem using my well water. But if you're using tap water from a city and you have chlorine and fluoride, then your base numbers are gonna be a lot different than my tap water here today. So please keep that in mind as well. Then the filtered water, I actually have a Berkey system, so it runs through a charcoal filter. It takes out some of the natural compounds or the salts in the water, but running it through the charcoal, it kind of gives different numbers, and I'm gonna show you how that works. And we're gonna check the minerals, the compounds, and the salts, which is the electrical conductivity of the water. I can tell you without even looking at this meter that my distilled water is gonna be sitting at zeros. That is actually what distilled water is where they actually remove all of the minerals, the compounds, the salts, and anything that is in your water. It's perfectly distilled. I already wrote down a distilled number EC of zero. I'm gonna be writing these down so we have a baseline as we go. Now my tap water for my EC is gonna be 0.4. I already have 0.4 of what you would think would be nutrients in my water, but it's actually not the food nutrients that your plant needs. It is just picking up the conductivity of any other minerals that are in my water. Now we're gonna go to the filtered water. My filtered water is actually at 0.5. Now, again, this is a beginner. I'm not gonna get into all the scientific studies, and I'd probably have to figure out why this is doing this, and it might be because of the charcoal filters that is making this one just a little bit higher. But this just shows the different levels and the different starting points of your water. Now we're gonna go to the pH. We're gonna try the pH of the distilled water. And these usually jump around. If your meters are jumping around and you're like, oh my gosh, Angie, it's like all over the place, it does take a second for it to settle down, and you're gonna wanna just kind of get a good balance. Now the distilled water pH is jumping between 7.8 all the way up to 8.0. It's kind of settling at 7.91. So we're gonna go ahead and do 7.91 on that one. And then on my tap water, I'm settling down at 6.73, so we're gonna use that number. And then let's look at the filtered water. Filtered water is 6.96, so again, a little bit higher. Now here comes the question of how much do I add? Well, you have to look at what your base numbers are, and these are just mason jars. These are not 15-gallon tanks. It is not a 5-gallon tub of a crack key or a 3-gallon tub of a deep water culture. So again, it's really hard to say how much you're gonna add. So let's start with the pH. Now my distilled water again was at 7.91. Any of your pHs, especially for beginning plants, you want them around 5.8 to 6.0. It kind of runs a little bit higher than that if you don't keep up on it every day. I'm just gonna pour some into this little cup. These I purchased on Amazon, and they are just little medical syringes. They measure out in milliliters, and this one is at 10 milliliters. Now, the more you do this and the more you're balancing out everything, you're going to know with my tap water, every time I'm adding a couple of gallons, I kind of have it figured out on how much I'm gonna add. But just for the sake of this video, I'm gonna do two, and we're gonna see. So I'm gonna take this one down to 6. Take this down to 4, and I'll take that one down to 2, and I'm gonna go ahead and stir this around, and I'll give a good stir in this one, and we'll give a good stir in here. Now, usually if you're running these in one of the iHarvest units, you're gonna want a whole cycle, like let that 15-minute water rainfall really mix. If you're using the fish tank wave makers, this is another reason why, because it's always gonna be keeping that stirring. And usually you're gonna wanna wait a little bit longer. So my pH on this one was 7.91, and I've already dropped down to 2.15. That's a really a big drop. Are you seeing where this gets a little confusing of, Angie, how much do I use? Are you using a little mason jar or are you using 15 gallons of water? It is very much just testing it, but I wanted you guys to see the differences. Now on the tap water, it took it down to 2.24 and that one was at 6.73. And then let's look in the filtered water, and this one was 6.96 and we are at 2.32. They are all very, very similar, even though some of our starting numbers were not the same. For some reason you think that your meter is off and it's not working properly, you can also get these pH strips. And you can get these in the pool section at like Walmart, or you can order these on Amazon. These are really great. And you're just gonna take one of these little strips out and you're gonna stick it in the water. So for this particular one, it doesn't read as low as what the pH is for right now, all staying really yellow. But if your pH was any higher, then they would start changing colors. Another way to test, if you have the iHarvest, this is gonna come in your kit. And these are also very similar to that of what you would use for your pool. I'm gonna use a nice clean one of these and I'm gonna suck some water out. I'm using the filtered water just because it's the one right in front of me. And I'm gonna fill this all the way up to the top. And then I'm gonna put just a couple drops of this. I'm gonna do 3 drops. And we're gonna shake it up. And if you look on these bottles, there are different colors all the way around the bottles. And that is where you're going to match. Now you can see how pink this is. And the reddish color on here is 4.0, and this is pretty pink. It's actually gonna be under that 4.0. These are good if you need a backup, but it really is just 4.0, 5.0, 6.0, 7.0. There's no exact number as what we were testing just before where we had the actual 2.15. All right, so now we're done with the pH down. But I want to throw in one more thing, maybe to confuse you, maybe not to confuse you. If for some reason your water has really, really low pH, then there is a product called pH Up. And pH Up is actually gonna do the opposite of pH Down. Your pH levels are like 0 or a 1.5, which is crazy, and you need it to come up to the 5.8, then you're gonna be using pH Up. You're gonna be doing it exactly like pH Down, you're just going the other direction. Now, what we're doing with the food is gonna change your EC, your nutrients you want to measure in that EC. But we're gonna do something with different types. Just for the sake of it, I'm gonna use the filtered water with the actual Arrow Garden plant food because this is something a little bit different and it is made or set up to use with the Arrow Gardens, and they just kind of have it all figured out for you. Arrow Garden says that this is all you need. They don't tell you that you have to measure anything. They don't tell you you have to test your pH. It is just use this and your plants grow. But if you want to actually have the best growth of your plants, then you really want all this balanced out. What I'm gonna do with the filtered water is I was at an EC of 0.5. I'm only going to add one of the milliliters because I know that the Arrow Garden is a little bit stronger. They recommend 2 capfuls for one of your Arrow Gardens. Let's go ahead and see what this changes. Now you're probably saying, Angie, why do we care about Arrow Garden food if we're doing an iHarvest? Well, I'll tell you, this is gonna show you the differences in the types of foods, in the type of nutrients. It was at 0.5. And now we are at 1.9. So I'm gonna go ahead and write that down. Just 1 milliliter took it from 0.5 to 1.9. Do you guys feel like you need to have like a notepad out? I really hope I'm not confusing you. And I'm sorry, but I really, every time I get these questions, this is what goes through my brain is what food are you using? What type of water are you using? What type of meters are you using, right? And you can see by this experiment why those questions are really important. Now, I like MaxiGrow from General Hydroponic because that is what came with my iHarvest and it's what I'm used to. It has a little scooper in it. And I always recommend using the smaller scooper because there's just so much more control. If you have filled this up for the very first time, then you might be able to get away with doing one big scoop at the beginning and then test everything. I like to do the little because I have more control. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna do a 1 into the tap water, and that's a lot of food. We're gonna see a really high EC. We're just gonna pretend that we're growing Swiss chards, the kale, like everything that likes the high EC. As I'm going to be stirring this, and I'll switch this to EC, this brings me to another question. What are you growing? So when you say, Angie, help me with my EC, what should my EC level be at? Well, what are you growing? Lettuces like a really low EC. And your Swiss chards and your kales and your tomatoes, anything that flowers, cucumbers, if you're doing squash, anything like that, peppers, they're all going to also want a higher EC. Now, this is another really cool demonstration, and I might just go ahead and lift these up so you guys can see. This is the distilled water with the food. Can you see how clear this still is? And now this is my tap water with the food, and you can see it is much more of a foggy color. And we did the exact same amount, and I stirred it for pretty much the same amount of time. And actually, this distilled water, the food is still just floating right down to the bottom and settling. My tap water, it's settling a little bit, but I can really see it moving around and spinning around in there. And it's actually dissolving a little bit faster in this than it is in the distilled. Yeah, the more I sit here and look at this, that distilled is just sinking to the bottom. Those are a little bit of a difference between using the distilled and the tapped. Again, when you're testing and you're running your systems, you might want to run 1 or 2 cycles depending on what kind of water you're using. And my tap water on the EC went from 0.4 to 6.2. Okay, now the distilled, which was at a perfect 0, is actually at 6.2. Now, if you can scientifically explain this to me, great. Leave me comments down below. That would be awesome. Because we had different EC levels to start between the distilled and the tap water. But if you're also gonna come in and say, but why are you using tap water again with the well water? It's really not making that much of a difference. But that one scoop really did kind of give me the same amount. Now, here is another kicker. So I could say one scoop per little mason jar is gonna take you to a perfect 6.2. But I don't know exactly how much water you're running in your tank. You may not know how much water is running in your tank and what else have you done to your food. So there's something else called Calmag, and just for the sake of it, we're gonna pretend that we're growing tomatoes. So I'm gonna pull out enough that I have 6 milliliters. Now we're really gonna play around because I'm gonna add 3 milliliters to each one of these. So if you are needing calcium, magnesium, or iron in any of your plants, if you're seeing like a browning out, anything on your leaves, if you really have anything that is flowering or producing, then you're going to want to add the Calmag. But I would wait on the Calmag. Don't do this when they're just tiny little plants. Now, in my tap water, adding the Calmag in my tap water took me up to 7.5. So I was at 6.2 and the Calmag took me to 7.5. Are you taking this into consideration when you're using your nutrients? You might want to back down on your regular nutrients if you're supplementing with Calmag. So let's go ahead and see what the distilled water did. And the distilled water went to 7.7. So it was also the 6.2. and it went to 7.7. So now there are 0.2 more EC in the distilled water than there is in the tap water. It really shows you that the Calmag is interacting with these waters a little bit differently. Now for the sake of just because, I'm gonna have somebody that says, but Angie, what about hydrogen peroxide? And for kicks and giggles, we're gonna do the same with the 2 milliliters of hydrogen peroxide per, so 2 in that one and 2 in that one, and we'll go ahead and give this a stir. If you guys have any more questions, if you're confused, I understand. Leave your questions and your comments down below. If you think this video is fun and you want to see me do more of these videos, then please subscribe, because you know, subscribing to the channel keeps me going, keeps me motivated. I see those numbers and I think, wow, somebody really cares what I'm talking about. I'm gonna turn this back on and let's see if the hydrogen peroxide affected our EC levels at all. And the tap water went from 7.5 to 7.6. We have a 0.1 EC off of the hydrogen peroxide. And the distilled water went from 7.7 and is still at 7.7. So the hydrogen peroxide did not have any interaction with the distilled water. So now you're probably asking, Angie, what was the point of all of this? I could say I don't really know. It was just really, really fun to do, and I thought you guys could experience it with me. But I also really wanted to reach out, explain this better than you getting messages back from me saying, well, what kind of food are you using? Are you using Calmag? Are you using hydrogen peroxide? How much water are you using? Is it 14 gallon? I really wanna be here for all of you guys. I really wanna be answering all of your questions and helping you out. And that is my biggest mission, is to continue doing this. My channel is called Grow With Angie because I want you guys to grow with me, and I'm growing as well. I mean, look at this, what a cool experiment. And I probably really would not have tried all of this if it wasn't for making these videos for you guys. I'd love to know what kind of tap water you guys are using as well. Let me know down below in the comments. And I hope you guys all enjoyed this. If you did, hit that like a button, and we will see you on the next episode of Grow with Angie.